BBC Radio Scotland.
Listen.
Recorded by Jackie Edwards, then covered by the Spencer Davis Group,
What a good song. What an absolute delight. You're listening to Ashley Storrie on BBC Radio Scotland live from Pacific K, joined as always by sidekick Silent Paul. And today we're talking freebies, we're talking hand-me-downs, we're talking about getting a bit of a blag. Have you ever managed to convince somebody to give you something for free? Get in touch via text 80295. Let us know your best free stuff story. What is it, Paul? Paul. I've got an email. Hello, Ashley and Silent Paul. Greetings from the state of Maine. The best free second-hand thing that I have is a red crab soap dish, which previously belonged to the actress Kelly Preston. She shopped at the store when I worked for a summer job and had bought said soap dish and then returned it, understandably, when she saw that it was missing a leg. My manager said that I could take it since we would throw it out anyway. It now lives on my side table and holds my keys and badge for work. Great to hear all of the covers. Thanks, Patrick. And they sent a picture of Kelly Preston's former crab soap dish. It's as good as you can imagine it being. It's perfect. Thank you so much for getting in touch and telling us about that.
If anybody's, it's a literal crab
holding like a oyster
one
shell.
Claw holding a shell with, you can then use
to
as a dish.
Put your soap in. Absolute brilliance of that. I do love a good soap dish.
The fact that Kelly Preston bought that at one time, was and that maybe to give it to...
The fact that she then returned it because
Travolta,
it was missing.
Was it, who was it she was previously? Was it Sean Penn?
I don't know. It's absolutely delightful though.
Who
I
was
don't
the
know.
Person that shot her by accident?
I don't know. And I don't know. And I don't know. I don't know the answer
we featured
to
them
three
on
questions.
One
but we'll look it up and we'll not just jump to conclusions and make guesses lest we say something libelous about Sean Penn. We've got a message here that says, Hi Ashley and Silent Paul, great to hear the show again. Always a great way to end the week. When you introduced the Whitney Houston song...
Oh, it was Charlie Sheen that shot.
There we go. Of course it was Charlie Sheen. When you introduced the Whitney Houston song that you were about to play, the title sounded like a Glaswegian... A retort to some unwelcome challenge, something along the lines of, what you are talk that you're going to say. I can't read that. I'm going to have to. Can you do it, Paul? Paul's laughing, he gets it. You do it. No. Hold on.
Talk that you're going to say to the boss tomorrow that you're not happy doing that and it's no part of your job specification. I bet you don't say anything. How will I know?
See, I knew you'd be better at it. It also feels specifically like a lot of the things Paul says. That does sound like you moaning about your work.
Aye, pretty much.
Get in touch via text. It's Ian from Trin. Thank you for that. I'm already regretting sending this. Don't regret sending us anything, Ian from Trin. We're always happy to hear from you. You can get in touch with us via text 80295 or you can email us. What's the email, Paul?
AshleyStorrieShow@bbc.co.uk. Perhaps you have a piece of furniture or paraphernalia that once belonged to a celebrity. Please get in touch.
Oh, I'm trying to think. Do I have it? Well...
Surely you must.
I've got Terry Pratchett's funeral water. Because when they had a service for him, this is so weird, because I loved Terry Pratchett, and it was my birthday and I was in London, and I met this woman and I said, oh, I'm really, really sad that Terry Pratchett died. And she was like, that's so weird that you should say this, because I was at his funeral. Here's a bottle of water from his funeral, and I've kept it ever since.
So what was the water? Just a drinking water?
Yeah, it was drinking water, but it was all like labelled with Ankh-Morpork, the place that he invented.
Oh, no, that's
so
nice.
So it was like from the river.
That's not weird at all.
It's kind of weird.
It's not really. No, that's nice.
Okay, good, because I constantly have to say to my parents, don't throw this away because it does just look like rubbish.
Is there water in it?
Yeah, I've not opened it and it's slowly like sooked itself in.
Maybe you should have emptied the water out of it.
No, that's the special water from the funeral. I don't want it. It's a minking dish.
I know, but the box... Oh, well, fair enough.
I've also got, because you bought me a Post Malone doll and my parents bought me a Post Malone doll, I've got one for playing with and one for keeping special.
What do you do with the one to play with?
I just move it about my room. Sit it on top of like owls and stuff so it looks like Post Malone's a never-ending story. I must have things that... I'll tell you.
Right.
I have Benedict Cumberbatch's coaster from when he won his first BAFTA for playing... Stephen Hawking.
Anyone knows Benedict Cumberbatch, would you give him it back if he wanted that
coaster.
Fantastic piece of memorabilia from a big night in his career.
Yes.
What would you swap him for?
Well, from him.
Yeah. He would. What would he have to give you to give him the coaster?
For Benedict Cumberbatch to receive his coaster from the night he won his first British Television Award.
Would he have to record in his best Benedict Cumberbatch maybe like 10 stings for the show?
10 stings for the show that all include the word penguin. Because he can't say that word. That's his Skellington.
I bet he's practiced it lots.
I bet he has practiced it. No, I'd probably rather just something from a Marvel film that I'd give to you because I know it would delight you.
Because I don't have the space for it.
Oh, you're rubbish. What would you like off Benedict Cumberbatch?
Oh, I don't know. Like a video, like a cameo, but he's got to do it like that time he played the dragon.
Yeah, Smaug. Yes.
Smaug, yes.
Smaug the dragon.
And he's all on the floor and he's giving it all the...
Yes! Okay, no, that's what... I would just want him to do that for 15 minutes in the studio for us.
If you ever... And the next time you're in Glasgow, Ashley, Benedict Cumberbatch, if you're listening...
I'm not giving
Ashley,
him his coaster back.
Why?
Because it's mine now, Finders Keepers.
If he agrees to come in here and lets us film...
Absolutely
lets us film
not.
Him coming live on the show, doing an interview, and then does a Smaug on
the floor. The coaster has a picture of Cinema Paradiso on it. I wanted it. I eyed it. I did not know who this guy was. He was like, oh, yes, I'm an actor. And I was like, I want that coaster. And I took that coaster because he wasn't interested in it. So I'm keeping that. I can't think of anything else cool I've got. I'll have a think because I've gumped a lot of people.
Yeah, you've pocket dipped some other celebrities.
That was one of my... I was watching an interview with a footballer who used to be a ball boy, and he said one of his favourite things was when he was a ball boy, he was just stealing gloves that had belonged to famous footballers.
Why not?
So yeah, Phil Foden from Manchester City.
Yeah, well, there you go.
When he was a ball boy, he was like, I used to just pick up, if MJ dropped any gloves, scarves, hats, take it, go home and be like, oh, look at that, that's a famous footballer's glove.
And now he's like one of the most famous footballers in the world.
Delightful. Get in touch via text at 0295.
And I bet you he never drops anything.
I bet he knows.
Like, no one's getting any of this stuff.
Indeed. Well, you would. Get in touch via text at 0295. Let us know if you have any items that once belonged to celebrities.
Yes.
That's my new favourite thing. Now, we played Tom Jones doing a cover of a song, and now we're going to play you Marvin Gaye doing a cover of a Tom Jones song.
Which originally was meant to be a song for Sandy Shaw.
But
Tom Jones did the demo for it just so that Sandy Shaw could listen to it. Sandy Shaw heard it, went,
nah.
Yeah, no chance. That guy should just do it.
Indeed.
Released it. Big hit.
But here's Marvin Gaye doing it with It's Not Unusual.
Roll the tape. I'm going to kill this one. Not unusual to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual to have